Afternoon and welcome to the concert of the Bowdoin Chamber Choir. Professor Jeff Christmas should be here welcoming you today, but unfortunately he contracted COVID. He's feeling better, but not yet clear to be here today. We're also down two tenors, Philip Bonanno and Sammy Durige. Fortunately, we have most of the choir, and they still are sounding very, very good. Professor Vinny Chende and I have stepped in to try to help in this concert in Jeff's absence, and also Thomas Mizuki and Timmy Solomini are stepping in as conductors for a couple pieces as well. I hope you enjoy the concert.
Thank you. Jeff asked me to say a couple of words about this next piece. So like most of the world, I was horrified and heartbroken about the Russian invasion of Ukraine. And, you know, I was trying to figure out what I could do as a composer. And sometime late February, I came across this amazing poem by the celebrated Ukrainian poet Boris Kazansky, where he called Misa in tempora belli, or Mass in Time of War. And in this poem, he took the traditional text of the Latin Mass, as well as its translation in the Church Slavonic version of that Latin Mass, and then interpolated that with commentary and kind of corruption of that text. So whereas the original text of the Latin Mass is all about the declaration and the celebration of faith, Kazansky's poem takes that to show that having blind faith in something, as in believing propaganda and everything like that, the evils that that can actually lead to. It's a very devastatingly beautiful and powerful poem. And so I looked at this and I thought the first section of it, the Kyrie, was something that I could quickly set and get out to choirs, you know, in hopes of raising awareness and hopefully funds for Ukrainian refugees and things like that. And so I quickly wrote a draft and, you know, through the magic of modern technology, got it to Boris Kazansky in Odessa. He gave me his blessing on it, and I sent it out to a bunch of choirs. That was my spring break, essentially, and what I did there. The piece itself deals with those moments of beauty as well as anguish and devastation and then ultimately resolution. And so you'll see that in the increase and decrease of dissonance throughout the piece. And there's a moment at the very end where I quote the Ukrainian national anthem. Which translates as Ukraine shall not perish. And so I allude to that text with that music while using the original Latin, or Greek, I should say, Kyrie, which means Lord have mercy, thereby kind of joining those two things together. I am absolutely grateful to you, Jeff, and these wonderful young men and women before you. This is not an easy piece, and you know they got it halfway through the semester, but they've really put their all into it, and so I have so much gratitude and appreciation for them. And as I said before, my main reason for writing this was to raise awareness for Ukraine. So, you know, if you do like the piece, well, heck, even if you don't like the piece, I hope that you can find, if you are able to, donate to Ukrainian refugees. There's some websites listed in the program. And thank you very much. I hope you enjoy the work.
Thank you. Ghost.